Hello everyone, welcome to Box Office India.
Thank you.
Could you just please give our viewers your introduction as exhibitor?
I am Dharmesh Datta from PVR.
I'm Mayank Shroff from Cinepolis India. I take care of film marketing and programming for the company.
Hi, I'm Saurabh Varma. I'm the CMO, INOX Leisure Ltd.
Hi, I'm Kunal Sawhney, Vice President Operations for Carnival Cinemas.
Great. And I'm Bhakti Mehta, hosting all of you today. So, we just wanted to discuss the year that has gone by, especially in cinema. We've seen, thankfully, a lot of ups rather than downs this year. So, I would want to know, how has it been from your perspective, from an exhibitor's perspective? How has this film, how has this year been for films?
Okay, so the change in trend for this year has been a lot of content-led films doing well at the box office, more acceptance of these films among the consumers. As we see, this year the ticket sales has been higher than the last quarter of this year, which is showing that in the underdeveloped markets like tier 2 and tier 3, the new multiplexes and screens that are coming up are making people come back to the theatres. More people are coming out and more films, they're watching more films in tier 1 theatres. So apart from the ticket price going up, there's a larger, the footfalls have gone higher, the occupancies have been higher this year.
Okay.
So that's a very big positive for the cinema industry. And it's not just the marquee films with A-listers which have guarantee of doing a good box office.
Yes.
It's, they are the ones which are really struggling, but it's the content-led high-quality movies which seem to be making their bucks at the box office.
Anybody else?
So we think scripts have been superstar. Not that A-listers have lost their value. Of course, Aamir Khan film taking the biggest opening of all time, 50 crore, breaking all the records in Bollywood. But at the same time, how do we justify films like Stree or Badhai Ho doing equal collections of Race 3? So that clearly says that scripts are new superstar. We have got a humongous surprise in regional, in Bollywood, where movies like Stree, Razi, 102 Not Out, Surma, Badhai Ho, Andhadhun have done phenomenally well, exceeded the expectation. And I agree with Dharmesh, at Cinepolis the trend is similar, and all the locations footfalls have increased with 3.5%.
So in my point of view, what has happened is that there is an exhibition and there is the people who create the content.
Mm-hmm.
From a creation of content perspective, there was always a kind of a division. So one division was that ye film sirf yahan chalti hai, ye film matlab Salman Khan film works everywhere, but everything else like a Badhai Ho will only be limited to a
single, like a multiplex audience,
multiplex cinema, yeah. Multiplex film hai,
yeah. Single screen film hai.
And there were a lot of apprehensions when Stree trailer came or Badhai Ho, ki achhi picture hai, but itne screens mein hi chalegi. I think that barrier has been broken. So I think that's a very, very interesting thing. The second most interesting thing which I feel is, and we as an exhibition industry think is that, and that's what my personal belief is, that when producers make a film and they plan a marketing around it, I think exhibition doesn't take that much of a priority. They would want to spend a lot more time in other things, which I'm not sure is that effective as much as, targeting the captive audience of exhibition.
Right.
So this year there is some element of seriousness for, filmmakers to focus on cinemas and cinema chains and say, hey, let me do a focused job in promoting my film there. So they would go to a Timbuktu to promote a film, but they may not look at, the serious audiences of, the cinema which they need to target. Yes, they would, but not to that extent.
Right.
So that mindset is also changing this year. So that's, I think, a very positive thing.
I think just to add, what we have seen this year is, from the previous years, there was a bulk of admits used to come in a particular season time or month. We have seen more consistent performance throughout the year. So it is not that Diwali was a bumper. October was very, very good. So all the months has performed equally well, which is probably a biggest change. And the change is probably because there's a lot of regional content which has worked in. So it's not no longer only Telugu which is working. We have a huge Marathi movie. Punjabi movie did really, really well. Gujarati has broken all the records. So these were some fillers which has filled in where there was no Bollywood movie. So this has been very good. This what happens is movie watching is a habit. If there is people wait for after Thugs Zero to come, in between if there is a couple of movies, they'll definitely come for a smaller movie also, which has helped. So it's not only Razi's 3 or the a movie like Tumbak, which is a yes. horror movie. We got the movie back after Diwali and till date it is doing very good footfalls. So you, if there is a content, people might even come back to watch it twice or thrice. The same has happened with Badai.
Right. But just to add on Tumbad, I mean from a marketing checklist point of view, it's got everything wrong. The title is not clear what it is. You know, the posters are dark, things are dark. But you know, the audience has been smart enough to smell a good film.
Right.
So I should compliment the makers because, you know, somewhere the product, the word of mouth, things have worked so much that, you know, people are coming to watch it.
Do you think that, you know, that has also worked because other films have not worked, mainly Thugs of Hindustan, which has not worked post-Diwali. Is that why, you know, there is even more collections for, say, a Badhai or Andhadhun or Tumbad?
I guess the surprises are every year. So every year you have a certain expectation of a certain film and it does not perform, and there are certain films which we generally use the term sleeper hits.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not that, you know, this year it's been unique. But yes, you know, a destiny of a film, you know, finds like film, hum kehte hain achhi film paani ki tarah hoti, it finds its way. So yes, Thugs was a threat to a lot of films, and you know, it not working is you know, a hit to the whole industry. But having said that, had Thugs work, even then Tumbad would have survived, because a good film can always survive, and so is Badaiyo, and so would, you know, other films. But the benchmarking of Badaiyo in comparison to other big films has really opened the eyes of a lot of content creators, and I hope more content like this comes.
Just like to add, now what happens is that when a big movie releases, it normally comes on a festival time where the ticket price is at peak. So if a bigger movie does 100 crores, you will want X number of people have watched the movie. But what happens in a smaller movie, it is not coming on a festival season, their ticket price is at least 30% lesser.
Right.
So number of viewers has increased as compared to what a bigger movie is. So the number, if Thugs does 100 crores, I'm sure Badaiyo 100 crore people have watched, more number of people have watched movie as compared to what Thugs has watched because of the ticket price.
Regional have been great surprise, even industry like Telugu, where a smaller or smallest film like Arjun Reddy is the biggest grosser for Telugu, one of the biggest grosser for Telugu. In Gujarati, Sudhir has broken all the
records. Yeah. Yeah.
In Marathi, Dr.
Yeah.
Kashyap.
Yeah.
Again,
Nal.
That is doing so well.
Yeah. Nal saved a week last week. I mean,
for Western India.
Maharashtra, it was very good. It almost survived the current month.
And if you see the film, if you see the whole dynamics, people have smelled a good film. So, I mean, that's very good.
So, as we said, you know, there were unexpected hits and there were shocking flops, you know, that we feel. Not only this year, but last year also we saw that. Last year it was more on the negative side because a lot of, there were more shocking flops than unexpected hits than this
it's
year.
It's more like life.
Yeah, exactly. So, just like life, is there anything that, you know, especially the last 2 years that have helped you plan a certain kind of strategy for the coming years, especially when there are big movies in question?
So, you know, what's happened is we've seen the evolution in the sensibilities of the audience. A large part of the movie-going audience is the millennials. And they seem to have developed and evolved, you know, and we see that they want high-quality content. They want to come to a theater which gives them a new experience. They're happy to pay a premium for it. So, with all these demographic changes, with the target audience changing, our strategy is becoming more, you know, like you want to give them a completely exemplary service excellence. You want to give them new age technology experience. You want to create an experience out of home which cannot be replicated anywhere else. So the strategy is moving towards premium and luxury cinema. Strategy is moving towards tier 2 and tier 3 cities where you know, there's a growth opportunity, where people have higher disposable incomes because they're not too many out of home entertainment options.
Right.
People are happy to pay a premium for these experiences in tier 2 or tier 3 cities. Real estate development is more you know, positive in tier 2 tier 3 cities. So the exhibition business is focusing on growth, is focusing on the kind of consumer expectations and how to meet them. Obviously, content is not in our control. It's funneled by consumer, consumption. So these are some of the key things that I could sense, which the exhibition industry is experiencing.
So we spoke about ticket prices, that you have said that it has increased, the footfalls have increased in the past year. But what we spoke to, you know, other tier 2 exhibitors, the smaller exhibitors and everything, they told me that people were waiting to go to the theatre because the ticket prices were so high. And then once the review came out and it was a negative review, then people just didn't opt for going. So, you know, is there any change that... Do ticket prices matter in such cases, especially when the fate of the film depends on just the weekend?
I think ticket prices is more like demands to supply. And ticket prices at Cinepolis and I believe other multiplexes are higher and lower both. Weekends and weekday and morning to night slot. It's all totally depending on the demand and supply. So it's not necessary like a lower ticket, with a lower ticket price, a movie can perform. We have seen last couple of weeks have been a lower footfall with the low ticket price, but the footfalls have been lower. So it has not helped increasing footfall. At the same time, with the higher ticket price also, we have seen festival movies. The content is good, the ticket price works. And I believe there's a myth that cinemas are increasing too much of ticket price, which we don't see.
Yeah.
We have been increasing, I think, yearly 3% of ticket pricing, which is lower than the inflation.
Sometimes it is dictated by you also.
This, see, what is happening is that the perception of ticket price is determined by the 5% of the cinemas in the nearby catchment. But it is not necessary that a Gorakhpur would have the same ticket price as a Juhu.
Right.
So the overall ticket prices, because we also are exhibition guys who are planning it right. And so if there is a person who is conscious and he doesn't want to pay more, he'll definitely wait for a Monday or a Tuesday for an offer. So we have offers on every day. It's like flights.
Right.
You know, if you want to go at a premium time, and if you compare our industry to hotels or flights, it's almost the similar.
Right.
It's just that the passion level of everybody is so high that they feel that the ticket prices are higher.
Right.
Having said that, you know, people wait or don't wait for the movie depending on the how well the film has been received by the audience.
Right.
If they would have liked the promo, if they like a promo of a certain film, nothing will stop them. If they don't like the promo, you give free tickets, they are not going to watch.
I just like to add, I totally agree to Mayank what he said. So ticket price is probably a myth which has now been created, ticket price is high. For a given movie, even if there is a festival and a movie is big, the ticket price goes up by 8% or 9%. The base of that cinema is already high. So there is no point of further taking it, the ticket price is high. If you want to watch a movie, there are tickets available at cheaper price also, but depending on the services what you want to opt. So it's like if I have decided to eat a burger, by adding a cheese to it or 20 rupees will not make a difference. If I want to see a movie, adding 20 rupees to it will not decide okay, I want to watch a movie or not. If they want to watch, if I am used to going a particular cinema where the average ticket price is 300 and the ticket price goes up by even 10%, which is only 30 rupees. So 30 rupees won't even matter. That's lesser than the parking charges.
Mm-hmm.
So it's the content which pulls the crowd.
Also, you all spoke about the festival films and how important do you think, because now we've seen festival films also not do well, but it's come and go, like let's say holiday films rather than festival films, like a Padmavat releasing during the Republic Day weekend did very well, but then a Sanju coming out on a non-holiday weekend also, you know, was the biggest grosser of the year. So what difference is there between non-holiday film and a holiday film?
I guess it's basically that you can get 3 days. I mean, if you look at the whole business, you divide it into 52 weeks. And in 52 weeks, you have 3 days, Friday, Saturday, Sunday into 52 is what we are targeting. The ticket prices are higher, the footfalls are higher. So when you get a holiday week, you get the fourth day as an advantage.
Right.
So that's a business math statistics. So that's an added advantage to a good film. Having said that, a good film cannot be stopped. So if a Sanju comes in a non-holiday as well, then also even the weekdays get a push. But it's a pre-planning strategy by the producers, which is a great strategy, because when you have holidays, which not the whole country is celebrating, but there is a holiday, they would like to go out in the evening.
Right.
I mean, earlier 10 years back, people never used to go to cinemas during Holi. They never used to go to cinemas during Diwali. Now people are looking forward to go to cinemas and celebrate the, you know, holiday and with watching a movie. So that trend is a good trend for films as well as exhibitors.
Right.
Plus if you see the biggest film of Indian cinema, Bahubali 2, yeah. In conclusion, it's a non-holiday.
Yes.
So, but it definitely makes sense as a strategy to gain added revenues if a big film, a good film is coming on a holiday.
Right. Also, I would like to talk about the consumption of Hollywood movies. How it has changed in India, you know, especially over the last three to five years. So, if you could just shed some light on that.
So, the sensibilities, like I said, you know, there's a change, there's evolution in sensibilities of consumption of content. And suddenly Hollywood cinema is appealing to a larger demographic within the country. Hollywood cinema is being planned a year in advance. There's a larger planning in terms of how the film is marketed, how the film is presented. There's a lot of franchisee and superhero cinema which is coming in, and it's actually giving a run for the money to the local cinema if the content's not strong enough. And with this whole digitalization, there is a buzz that comes in when a strong Hollywood film comes in,
right,
with an A-lister. So that entire buzz is driving the moviegoer to the cinema. It's apart from whatever is being done locally, the international buzz is becoming a huge impetus for consumers to go and consume Hollywood.
Right.
So Hollywood is on a, while it has local and regional content to compete with, mm-hmm. It is getting a wider audience. The dubbing further is, getting getting the crossover, cinema goer to watch Hollywood. So there is growth in the Hollywood segment, and it will continue to happen till the time Hollywood has these big event films and, these franchisee and superhero films, which have the mass of the Hollywood market.